Welcome to VITEEE 2024 Aptitude Practice Series Part 3. In today's video, we are going to concentrate on data sufficiency related questions. If you are new to our channel, please subscribe our channel so that you do not miss out on any important notification. Let's start our video. Now, the first question is asking, what is Reena's rank in the class? Here, in data sufficiency related questions, we are actually provided with one question, and in the follow-up, we are provided with the two statements. Basically, in these questions, we are also provided with the four or five options, and we should be able to tell if the first statement is sufficient or if the second statement is sufficient, or if either of one or two statements are sufficient to answer the question, or if we have to combine both the statements and would be able to answer the question. Accordingly, we mark our option as the answer. And fifth case also exists, which is not provided here, which is like neither one or two nor two statements are sufficient to answer the question. So here, first statement is asking, second statement alone is asking, third option is given as either one or two, and fourth option is provided as data in both of the statements together is needed to answer the question. Let's try this question. What if we look at the just first statement? So by this, we won't be able to answer what is asked in the question. If we now focus on the second statement, which is written as there are 9 students who have scored less than Reena. But by this fact, we won't be able to tell the Reena's rank. What if we merge both the statements? So here now we can say that there are 9 students below Reena, but there are 26 students. So there are 9 students below Reena, and Reena's position would be 10th from the last. Okay, because now there are other students who have scored above Reena. Now there are 9 students and there are 10. So basically there are 16 students remaining who have scored above Reena. So 17th seems to be the rank of the Reena. So both the statements are necessary, and in this manner, option D would be our answer. Now, before moving forward, if you want to boost your VITEEE preparation, we have brought a VITEEE 2024 Warrior Batch for you. Here you are getting aptitude and English lectures, best short trick sessions, so that you can boost your speed for VITEEE exam. And also time is very less. So you need to get a very adequate practice, and definitely this course will be very helpful. As you hear, you are getting short notes, mock test series, exclusive question bank, and also access to the live sessions. So this course will definitely be able to boost your score in the actual exam. One important thing, limited time period, ₹500 off discount coupon code is there. Please go and avail the offer. All the details are provided in the description box. You can also check out for the procedure for enrollment over there. For more course details, you can visit our website 10qchallenge.in. And one most striking feature of this course is that medium of instruction of the course is purely in English for the ease of understanding of everyone. Coming back to our questions. Now, the question is saying, is Arun taller than Sachin? So this is next question. Here we are having statements. Dinesh is of same height as of Arun and Sachin. Second statement tells us Sachin is not shorter than Dinesh. So can we, by using the first statement, can we be able to answer the question, is Arun taller than Sachin? So it is asking Arun taller than Sachin. So the first statement is saying Dinesh is of same height as Arun and Sachin. If Dinesh height is equal to Arun and Dinesh height is equal to Sachin, then from this we can infer that Arun and Sachin both are having the same height. Both are having the same height. Now can we say what is asked in the question, Arun taller than Sachin? So if both are having the same height, then Arun and Sachin are having the same height. So Arun is not taller than Sachin. So by the first statement itself, we are able to answer the question. So if the data in statement one alone is sufficient and Sachin is not shorter than Dinesh, so we even not need to focus on this, but what if we just consider this, so that if data either in one or two alone is sufficient, so there might be a possibility. So Sachin height is not shorter than Dinesh. Okay, so it is telling like this. From statement one, we have already concluded that the Arun and Sachin are having the same height and Arun is not taller than the Sachin. Okay, that's why only the first statement is enough. Statement two even is not needed. Now let's move to the next question. How is D related to A? First statement is saying B is the brother of A, and second statement is saying B is D's son. So first statement, if we focus at first statement, B is the brother of A. And if we look at the second statement, it is saying B is D's son. So if we combine both the statement, we might be able to answer this question, because like by saying B is the brother of A, we won't be able to establish the relation between D and A. And if we focus on the second statement, B is the sun. Again, alone we cannot use the statement 2 to answer the question. But if we merge both the statements, we can say the answer as B is the brother of A and B is D's son. It means that D is the father of B and B is the brother of A. So D is the father of A. So that seems to be our answer. So D is the father of A. So in this manner, both the statements are needed. Final answer would be option D. Now let's come to the next question. So next question is saying, how many New Year's greeting cards are sold in your shop? So this year, how many greeting cards were sold? First statement is saying, last year 2935 cards were sold. So this data is about the last year. So by statement one alone, we cannot tell how many greeting cards were sold this year. But if we focus on the second option, it is saying, second statement is saying, the number of cards sold this year was 1.2 times that of the last year. So here we are getting some idea. But can we tell by how many? The number is still missing. But if we merge both the data, both the statements, we will be comfortably able to answer what is asked in the question. So again, here 2935 into 1.2 equals to 3522. So these many cards were sold this year. So here both the statements were needed. So our final answer would be option D. Both the statements are required. Now, what time did the train leave today? This is the next question. Statement 1 is saying that train normally leaves on time. The train normally leaves on time. This is a very vague statement because the question is asking what time did the train leave today. So it is not answering our question. Now second statement, the scheduled departure is at 2:30. Is it about today? Is it about tomorrow? Is it about day after tomorrow? Which date basically it is talking about? Again, this is the second statement is also very vague. So here from 1 or 2 alone also and by combining them also, we cannot establish the fact what is asked in the question. So basically here D option would be our answer because the exact time of departure for the train of today, this cannot be revealed. So our answer would be option D. Hopefully you have understood how basically we are approaching these questions and how we are able to answer these questions. So this is the right approach needed to answer the data sufficiency related questions. Hopefully you have found this video quite useful. Please like this video, subscribe to our channel, share this with your friends who are also preparing for VITEEE, and also do check out the VITEEE Warrior Batch. All the details are provided in the description box. Keep preparing. We will come up with the new topic in the upcoming videos. Stay tuned. Jai Hind. Thank you. God bless you.